It's Sunday afternoon, and I am about to draft for one of my fantasy football leagues, actually. My family friends league, so I'm looking forward to that. But otherwise, I have just been packing up my shit, basically. My whole area over here has been pretty messy, so I'm just trying to get all that cleaned up and packed up for my new office. Slowly but surely getting the place packed up, it's been less than fun, but I guess it's just part of moving. So that's what we're doing today. Kendall's actually filming an exciting video for you guys, so. But yeah, that's pretty much what we've been up to this weekend. We're moving on Friday, so don't have that much time left before we have to get out of here.
Hey pals, Sunday afternoon. I just got done filming. We have been doing packing like all weekend, so really boring. It's so funny, when I film, I always feel like my videos just suck. Like afterwards, I'm like, that was awful. And then I start editing, I'm like, okay, this isn't bad. Yeah, when you're filming, when you're not getting a reaction from people and you're just sitting there talking to a camera, it always feels like it sucks. I think that's why so many people that do YouTube or like start a YouTube channel and give up, that's like the hardest thing to get over is like, the filming part can be very difficult. So clearly we still have a lot to pack up. I actually cleaned up my nightstand last night, which was a huge mess. So I'm in the process of like organizing all that. Still, we still have so much to go though. It's crazy. Yesterday I got this room pretty much packed up, all the stuff. And we actually have a ton of boxes in our garage. We parked my car somewhere else so that we can have the garage for putting boxes in. That way, since we're paying movers by the hour, they don't have to keep coming up to get boxes because we've moved them all slowly down throughout the weeks. So there's a ton of boxes in there with like a bunch of my stuff. And a ton of our stuff, we got rid of tons of clothes. If you saw our last vlog, we have boxes and boxes in the car right now. Josh is gonna take them to Peak Thrift tomorrow, which is actually an awesome organization, you guys. If you live in Denver, check out Peak Thrift because it's under Urban Peak. It's a homeless youth shelter and group in Colorado, and they have a thrift department, and anything that gets donated there is sold. 100% of the money that they make from selling the stuff goes to the homeless youth. They also are allowed to work there. They're allowed to shop there for free and get like stuff for interviews and stuff. And it's a great place. I think a lot of people, when they donate stuff, they don't do research into where they're donating and if it's really gonna help people. So yeah, making a huge donation to them tomorrow. And then, oh yeah, I have been putting this off, but this is all the makeup that I'm getting rid of. Literally tons of it. I cleaned out so much of my makeup drawer that I had three extra drawers for other things. Like, I cleaned it out pretty good. So I wanna send this to an organization. I actually found through my friend Taylor here on YouTube, and it's called Project Beauty Share. And you send any used cosmetics to them and they like sanitize them and give it to people who are in need. I know there's a lot of women out there who can't afford the luxury of makeup and stuff, so I feel like it's really important that this goes to someone because I just don't use it anymore. So I'm hoping to fit it all in this flat rate box, but that might be kind of hard. I'm actually thinking I'll be able to fit it all in this box. So let's hope. Oh yeah, this should work, no problem. I'll definitely be able to fit it all in there. So everything fit just fine into the box. I'm putting some bubble wrap on it because this is being shipped to Washington. Don't want it to, you know, go all over the place.
Just finishing my draft here. It's left.
Are you doing good? My dad's in this league too.
Yeah, and your Uncle Mark is too.
Oh yeah, and Janelle's boyfriend John.
And John, yeah.
So we weren't vlogging at this point, but in 2012, before we got little Meatball, because she was a replacement, we had another cat. Her name was Sadie, and she only lived for about 6 months, but she was like my favorite cat. She was so cute. She's such a good little cat. And it's a whole story. We don't even know what happened to her. We think she had some type of like disease that paralyzed her whole body. It was like terrible, but we kept her ashes and I've had them like in this box along with this. I think we should put this on our Christmas tree, Josh. But I don't know really what to do with it. It feels weird that her ashes just sit in our closet. So maybe we should like have a ceremony and let them go. Should we do that, Mimi Sue? You were the replacement. House mom in our house at our sorority, her cat just had kittens that same week. So we got Meatball within days after. Hey guys. Hi buddy. Say hi. And Bernie is here too. Just got some Panera. Lunch for daddy. He's gotten so much better with car rides. Sitting back now, and then I actually have a doctor's appointment later today.
Oh. All right, so I am actually at Peak Thrift because we had tons of stuff, especially Kendall had tons of clothes as you can see behind me, all the stuff back there we are donating to a place called Peak Thrift, which is a great place to donate to if you are in the Denver area. It's just off I-70 and Pecos Street. Hey, so I'm gonna pull down to the ramp and they're gonna unload it.
So we're sort of getting packed up in the kitchen. This is like the most dreaded part of this. Deciding what we still need to keep. I'm like, does this have a fucking match to it? Look how bad we were. We stained the shit out of this. I think it's finally starting to set in that we are out of here. Like, this is our last couple nights in this place. It's so weird. And we're moving into our first house together. It's very exciting. Are you excited?
I'm pumped.
Dude, okay, so we have like, literally, babe, we have like four vanillas. Excessive.
No,
I think cats are much more intuitive and they have a sense that we're moving because Tucker's just been like tweaking out over here. What's wrong? He looks like he like knows what's happening. This is our fourth move with him though.
He knows we're leaving again.
He's getting really tired, so I'm gonna go to sleep. I'm so overwhelmed. We have so much to do. We probably will not vlog until moving day because we're gonna just have a lot going on, or maybe closing day, but yeah, I'm really tired as you can tell, and I got soap in my eye just now, so I am gonna go to sleep. I hope you guys are having a great day, and we will see you later, vlog fam.